Hey everyone, in this video I'm going to go through the derivation of the speed of sound. So the overall goal, is to derive the equation that shows how the sound speed varies with state variables such as pressure, density, and temperature. And the way that we're going to do this is to use the 1D mass conservation and 1D momentum conservation equations that I've derived in previous videos linked to here and in the video description. I'll be solving for the equation, the general equation for any gas, and then I will simplify down that equation to the more general form that you've probably seen for a perfect gas. So what exactly is the speed of sound? The speed of sound is how fast a disturbance propagates through a medium. So in this case, my voice propagating through the air down to my microphone. So you can see I've drawn an infinitesimally weak wave over here as this black squiggle, and I've drawn a control volume around it in the dashed black, and we have states 1 and state 2. And from state 1, you can see that we have the velocity A, pressure P, density rho, temperature T, and on the other side, state 2, we have the velocity A plus some infinitesimally small change in velocity dA, and then the same for the other ones. And you can see here I've written that these values go to zero because this is an infinitesimally weak wave. I think it's important to discuss frame of reference first because otherwise this picture doesn't really mean much. So there's two frames of reference that we're looking at. The first one is imagine yourself riding on this wave, just sitting on the wave and riding along with it. And the second frame of reference is watching the wave pass by. So we're standing in a room and we're watching this wave pass by us. I think the first frame of reference makes most sense when you're looking at this control volume and looking at the terms, but the second one makes most sense just intuitively when you're thinking about it because you can think about it from personal experience. So let's just start with the first frame of reference and imagine that you're riding with the wave. You jumped on this wave and to you the wave is stationary because you're sitting on it, but what you see is you're traveling, you're actually traveling with the speed of, at the velocity of the speed of sound, okay? And that means that the flow is coming towards you. To you it looks like the flow is coming towards you with velocity A. And now if you look behind you, it looks like the flow is moving away from you faster than it's coming at you. And that's where this plus dA term comes in, because it appears as if the flow has sped up and is moving faster away from you. But it's an infinitesimally small amount, so all these d terms here, they go to zero. Now if we look at the second frame of reference, in this case you're standing and you're watching the wave pass by. And so in front of the wave, you have it looks like there's zero velocity, nothing's moving. And then you have this wave pass by, moving at the speed of sound. And behind it, it looks like the velocity has increased by an amount dA, a very, very small amount dA. And so the best way to think about this in the sense that the dA is very small is just to think about somebody talking to you, right? These sound waves are coming into your ear, but you don't feel this rush of air over your body every time somebody talks to you. So both of these frames or references are correct. It's just whichever way you want to think about it, whichever way makes most sense to you, use that method of thinking. So let's get started now. We're going to use the 1D mass momentum equations that are shown down here, and we're going to implement this state 1 and state 2 and plug them in, and we're going to try to solve for the speed of sound A. Okay, we're starting with the 1D mass conservation equation shown up here. Rho 1 U1 is equal to rho 2 U2. Now we're talking about state 1 and state 2, color coordinated over here. The rho on this side is rho, and the U on this side is A, so we have rho A, and then same for on the other side, but now we're using rho plus d rho and A plus dA, and so we're plugging that in here and here for this and this. And so now we're just going to multiply out the terms here, so we're going to do the first, which is rho times A, and then we're going to do the inner, which is A times d rho, plus the outer, which is rho times dA, plus the final, or the last, d rho times dA. So we've just expanded this out. And then what we can do is say that these terms here will cancel. Okay? And then this term here is a product of two infinitesimally small differentials, which means this is going to be negligible. So we can get rid of that. And what you end up with is 0 is equal to a d rho plus rho dA, and I'm just moving the a d rho to the other side. And I have negative a d rho is equal to rho dA. So now we have the 1D conservation of momentum equation rewritten here. We're going to plug in states 1 and 2 like we did before. This is just the left side of the equation. We're plugging in these terms for the right-hand side, and here is the U squared term, so I've just rewritten it, or written it like this with the terms spelled out so that I can multiply them through. It's a little bit easier to factor through. So in this step here, on this line, all I've done is just multiplied this through, factor this through. So we have the a squared, and then we have the outer and inner together combined for 2a dA, and then plus dA squared. Okay, and then we can say here, dA squared, as we said before, products of differentials are going to be small and negligible. And so in this step here, all I've done is now distributed this through by with these two terms. So we can do the first, which is rho a squared, and then here we have this term and this term as 2 rho a dA, and then we have a squared d rho, and then we have the 2a dA times d rho, or 2a d rho dA. You can see this is a product of two differentials again, so we can get rid of that one. And now, if you look to this side of the equation, we have p and p, and those will cancel out. We also have rho a squared and rho a squared, and those will cancel out. And what we're left with in this next equation is 0 is equal to dp plus 2 rho a dA plus a squared d rho. And so what we're going to try to do is solve for dA. So I'm going to move this term to the other side, and I have negative 2 rho a dA is equal to dp plus a squared d rho. And now if I divide through by negative 2 rho a, then I'm solving for dA, and we end up with dA is equal to the dp plus a squared d rho, that's on the top, divided by negative 2 rho a. All right, so now I've just summed up here what we got from mass and momentum. You see these two equations, and what we're going to do is plug in dA, this equation here, up into the dA and the mass conservation equation. And so that's written down here. So we have the negative a d rho here times rho, and I plugged in this into here. And now we can do some simplification. So we can see that there is a negative on both sides, so we'll just get rid of that negative. You can see, get rid of the negative. There's a rho numerator, rho in the denominator. We can get rid of the rho. Okay, and so we're left with a d rho, that's here, and then I'm just going to separate out these two terms. So we have dp over 2a, that's here, and then we have a squared d rho over 2a, that's here. And this term, you can notice that we can drop the squared and get rid of that a, so it's just a d rho over 2. Okay, and then what we want to do is just multiply through this equation, the whole thing, by 2a. You're going to get it out of the denominator here. So we'll have 2a times a d rho, so that'll give us 2a squared d rho over here. The 2a is going to cancel with this one here, so we'll just have dp. And then here, we had the a d rho over 2. If we multiply through by the 2's cancel. A times a gives us a squared, and we still have this d rho, so we have a squared d rho. We're going to subtract a squared d rho from both sides, so we're going to subtract this term from both sides. You can see that this is just 2a squared d rho, so what we're left with is 1a squared d rho, that's this. This term subtracted off, and we're just left with dp. And if we solve for a squared, we get a squared is equal to dp over d rho. So here I've rewritten the speed of sound definition, or speed of sound squared, is equal to change in pressure over the change in density. And let's see if we can say something about this type of flow. We'll take a look at the equation for the entropy change of the flow, and it's given by this equation that I'll derive in another video. But it's the specific heat at constant pressure times the natural log of the temperature ratio minus the specific gas constant times the natural log of the pressure ratio. And so for T2 and T1, we're just going to plug in T2, which is going to be T plus DT, T1 is just going to be T, and similarly for P2 and P1, as you can see here and here. So in the numerator, T plus DT over T, here, P plus DP over P. And if I, again, separate these out, so I have T over T plus DT over T, I end up having 1 plus DT over T, and then same here, 1 plus DP over P. But as we noted before, these are infinitesimally small changes across this wave, so DT goes to 0, dp goes to 0, which means that these terms go to 0. Okay, and we're left with just natural log of 1, natural log of 1, both of these are 0, so we have 0 minus 0, and this gives us that the entropy change is 0, which means that this is an isentropic wave. Okay, so now that we know that the process is isentropic, we can write the final form of the speed of sound equation as A is equal to the square root of the change in pressure over the change in density at constant entropy, and that S at the bottom just means it's isentropic. And I've changed these to partial derivatives just because pressure is not only a function of density, but also other variables. And this equation is valid for all gases, but now we'd like to simplify this for an ideal gas, which is probably what you've seen before. And so we're going to start with the polytropic process equation here. And this is an equation that just relates two of the state variables, the pressure and the specific volume here. So we have PV to some value n is equal to a constant. And for an isentropic process, N is equal to gamma, where gamma is the ratio of specific heats, Cp over Cv. So we can write Pv to the gamma is equal to a constant for an isentropic process, and this is where density is equal to 1 over the specific volume. You can see here the units, where density is kilograms per meter cubed, specific volume is meters cubed per kilogram. Okay, so up here we have the PV to the gamma is equal to a constant, C is a constant, and so I can also rewrite this as just P over rho to the gamma is equal to a constant, and I'll just move this to the other side, so we have P is equal to a constant times rho to the gamma. Now if we take this term, which you'll remember is A squared, to be just down squared, we're just going to take the derivative of the pressure with respect to the density, so that's derivative of this term with respect to the density, and you can see that we're just going to take the gamma down here and then take off 1 from the power. So we have gamma C rho to the gamma minus 1. We can rewrite this as this gamma C, and then we have rho to the gamma, and then the minus 1 we'll just bring down to the bottom here. And separating this out, we have gamma over rho, separate that out here, and then we have left is C rho to the gamma, and you'll note that that's just P from up here. So we can plug that in, and we just have A squared is equal to gamma rho times P, or gamma P over rho. And so now we'll use the ideal gas law. You can leave it in that form, and that's fine as well if you know pressure and density, but the more familiar form happens when we take the ideal gas law, P equals rho RT, divide through by density on both sides to get P over rho is equal to RT, plug in for P over rho in this equation, and we end up with A squared is equal to gamma RT, and so the speed of sound is equal to the square root of the specific heat ratio times the specific gas constant times the temperature. Thanks for watching.